silent. We will not be silent. So much more. Come and praise the Father, worthy as He is. There's no greater joy than to worship Him.
We worship Him. I lay down. Magnify Your name above all else, and in Your praise I'll dance, and in Your praise I'll sing, and in Your praise I'll dance, and in Your praise I'll give You everything.
Come on, holy people, lift Your holy roar, and our God is deserving. Tell Him He's mighty,
You're mighty.
And tell Him He's holy,
You're holy.
And tell Him He's worthy,
You're worthy.
And of our praise. And tell Him He's faithful,
You're faithful.
And He's gracious,
and gracious.
Tell Him He's worthy.
Set my feet on solid ground, Yours now forever. Nothing's gonna hold me, don't let it. Nothing's gonna hold me back, yeah. Nothing's gonna hold me back. My chains fell off, my heart was free. Amazing love, how can it be? Oh, you gave my sin and shame away. The slate is clean, a brand new day. Free now forever. Come boldly I approach your throne to claim this crown. Deserve my praise and more for all you've done, Lord. We're so grateful. We're so thankful, Lord. Let's give Him some praise this morning. Thank you, great God. Hallelujah.
Rising to the setting sun, His love endures forever. Oh, by the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise. Yes, we will sing praise. Come on, one more time. Sing praise. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God
Well, good evening, everybody, and thank you so much for joining us again tonight. We are here again for another great testimony from Ben and Joe Marr. You might have seen them around at church. We are going to hear a really great testimony from them this evening, and I know we're going to be blessed by it, aren't we? Because sharing about what God has done and how God has worked in our lives again and again. And today, we're going to thank Him for His love. We're going to sing a song this evening together called Here Is Love Vast as the Ocean. But before we get there, I just want to pray for us before we get going. All right, let's pray. Lord God, we want to thank you so much for this evening and for everybody gathered together tonight. I pray you will bless us as we hear your words and hear what you have done once again. Amazing things in people's lives, and we know that we can all say that you have done great things in all of our lives, Lord. Not only just the stuff day to day, but we thank you for your grace and your forgiveness and your work on the cross. And tonight, Lord, we say thank you, thank you, thank you. God bless all those in our church and who are with us who are ill and need a touch from you. God, heal them, bless them. You know who they are, you know where they are. God, those who are feeling lonely this evening, God, touch them and bless them, be with them, help them feel comforted tonight. And Lord, I pray you'll just help us have a great time together this evening until we see each other again on Sunday. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, everybody. Come on, let's sing this song together. Here is love vast as the ocean. What a great God it is we sing to. This is our time to give him praise and declare what he's done again. Here we go.
Here is love vast as the ocean, loving kindness as the flood. When the price of life, our ransom, shed for us his precious blood. Who his love will not remember? Who can cease to sing his praise? He can never be forgotten. Throughout heaven's eternal days. Thank you, Lord. And on the mount of crucifixion, fountains open deep and wide, and through the flood gates of God's mercy flowed a vast and gracious tide. Grace and love like mighty rivers poured incessant from above, and heaven's peace and perfect justice kissed a guilty world in love. Let me all thy love accepting, love thee ever all my days. Let me seek thy kingdom only, and my life be to thy praise. And thou alone shall be my glory, nothing in the world I see. Thou hast cleansed and sanctified me, thou thyself hast set me free. Thou alone is my glory, Lord. And in thy truth thou dost direct me, by thy Spirit through thy word and thy grace my need is meeting, as I trust in you, my Lord. And of thy fullness thou art pouring thy great love and power on me, without measure, full and boundless, drawing out my heart to thee.
Amen.
And the word of our testimony.
Thank you so much for joining us this evening for the next in our thrilling installment of This Is My Story, The Power of Testimony. You know, when Jesus comes and changes your life, when Jesus comes and he gets involved in your life, when Jesus comes and he starts to take you step by step through your journey, you will develop a testimony. Somebody said this, that, you know, life has got problems in it like a test. But you could never have a testimony until you've had a few tests in your life. So life is a mixture, isn't it, of great things and challenging things. And it's how we respond to God's guidance, God's goodness, God's direction in our life as to how our lives work out. And that becomes our story. You've got a story. I've got a story. And this evening, I am with a very beautiful couple, Ben and Joanne. We love you. We're glad that you've taken part in this evening. And this evening is all about your story. So welcome to our program, and it's really, really good that we've got this opportunity to unpack the story. You know, what we're going to start off with is asking the question, so who is Ben and who is Joanne, and where did you guys come from? Now, I know that's Hong Kong, but where, you know, how did you come from where you were to where you are now? Tell us a little bit about your family, where you come from, your background, so that people can put this picture in a picture frame. Who's going to go first?
Yeah, let me go first. Okay. I'm Ben, and my family have five people, my parents and my two youngest brother.
Youngest.
So I'm the eldest. Wow. Yeah, and I went to church since I was very young, even a baby. And I serve in church, and I really have a heart to serve God in my whole life. So for 20 something years later, actually, is this 4 months after we get married, God sent me to the Bible college in Hong Kong to start my 4 years full-time degree program. Wow. In theology. So it really changed my life. And after this 4 years, after I graduate, we serve in the churches in Hong Kong as a pastor for around 5 years. And God sent us again to another place, sent us to UK, sent our family to UK. And it's really exciting. I can describe it. This is a new adventure for us, especially in spiritual adventure.
We're going to ask you some questions about the UK and why you did that in a little bit. Just I'm really interested in just the backstory of Ben at the moment. So yeah. One of five, grew up in Hong Kong, went to Bible school, became a pastor.
Yeah.
And here we are. Joanne, tell us a bit about your story.
My name is Joanne, and I grew up in a non-Christian family. Ah. So I never heard about Jesus until I was 11 years old. I was playing in a playground in a street, and then some minister approached me and invited me to church, to the church he located in, and then
you went to his church?
Yes.
That's what happened for me and Rachel. I went to her church.
Oh.
I was the preacher and I saw her in the congregation. So church is a very good way to get together, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, so carry on.
Yes, and then after a few years, because of my rebellions, I left the church. But when I prepared for my A-level exam, I asked myself, what is the purpose of life? And then God sent a sister to me and invited me to the church again. And then I repent, and then
Was he still there?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, okay, good.
And then I repent, and I offer my life to God.
Great.
And then, yeah, one of my goals, of course, is to marry someone who is very godly. Yeah, so I did it. Yeah, and then I become career lady. I work in a pharmaceutical company before, and then now I'm now in UK. I am a full-time mom. Yeah, taking care of three lovely children.
Fantastic! That's absolutely great. You went to his church. Did you fall in love with the pastor then? Is that what's happened? Because we've got to talk about the romance bit now, haven't we? What happened? How did you guys get together?
When I back to church again, I really want to serve God. So I participate in many serving positions. Worship team, cell group leader, assisting in Sunday school. And then some of the position Ben also get involved. Uh-huh. That's why we have a lot of chance to talk. We have a lot of chance to pray together. So I think this is the platform for us to develop our relationship.
Great. And what about you then? Did you notice her quickly?
Actually, I know her when we were in secondary school, and because we are the same age, so we went to the same classes in Sunday school. Yeah, and she is one of the my competitor, because every year we have a prize who is the best. The best student. So
I'm not going to ask who won.
before she came to the church, no competitor at all. But after she was there, well, she is the one.
Oh yeah.
So but we really thank God that after she once again she came back to the church when she was in university. We served God together. We lead the cell group together. And we did worship together. We really enjoy it, and we have I remember one special moment. We get the touch and have some fire, and at that moment the cell group have a prayer night. So the prayer night, I'm the one to call her. You have to pray in the phone. And the first time I call her, oh, it's very dangerous. We talk over lights. yeah. I just remember that. Yeah. We talk over light, and that I think that is the special.
That's when the moment happened.
Yes.
And you knew that she was.
Yeah, I know she is the one.
Yeah. And then obviously you got married. Tell us a little bit about your wedding. What's a Hong Kong wedding like?
We actually it takes 4 days.
Four days.
The whole day.
The whole day.
From
okay.
early morning
yeah.
to midnight nearly. Yeah. And in the morning we have many brothers and sisters in church join us for the team as a team. Go to her house first, play some games, and visit all her relatives and bring her to my house. And also play some games.
Well, I'm gonna.
Yeah, we.
What sort of games?
We love to play wedding games there.
Wedding games. What are the wedding games like?
The sister will prepare a few sets of challenge. So they challenge him and also a group of brothers, and then to complete those challenges. So usually three kind of challenge. So if you complete the three kind of challenges, then you can get the bride.
Do you know something? I think we're learning something here, and I think the British people need to learn how to play games on their wedding day. And that's a fantastic thing, isn't it? Wow, how amazing. Come on, I'm interested in this story now. Come on,
yeah, keep going. And in the afternoon, we went to church and for the wedding ceremony, and there was lots of people. It's around 400 to 500 people. All our friends, our classmates, our brother and sister in churches, our relative, to celebrate for the whole afternoon.
And I bet she was a beautiful bride.
Yes, of course.
Of course.
Yeah.
And then obviously you've got beautiful kids. Tell us about having your children.
Yeah.
Yes. After we got married, and then I have experience of miscarriage first, and then he went to the Bible college. After that, after 1 year, and then I give birth to Hugo, and then we have George and Serena. Yeah.
And what a joy it must have been for you this last, just recently, to baptize your own son Hugo.
Yeah, that was amazing moment I've ever think about that, because actually Hugo want to get baptized last year. He came to us and talked about that, but we just put it in our hearts and asked him to pray more about that. And this year he come again. Yeah, we haven't talked about that, and we really saw his heart to God, and we really happy about that, and really thanks church and Apostle Jens to give me the privilege. This is really a privilege to baptize for my son.
Oh, it was a joy. So let us think of now just about you. Okay, you've got married, you've got your kids. So you got on an airplane, you came to the UK. Why? And what's all that about?
Actually, the moment was in 2017. When our eldest son Hugo quite struggling in the primary school, and he got some emotion issue. So we try to explore the opportunity to stay somewhere else, because we all know that the education system in Hong Kong is really not suitable for children, we can say that. So we actually in 2017 we went to UK to have a look and see if any opportunity or any way that got open for us. And we really fans got she know a friends in Leeds. So in 2017 we went to Leeds and stay in that friend's house. She haven't met that friends for over 10 years. And we haven't known that friend is a pastor already. Yeah, so when we stay in his house and talk a lot, and he introduced some Chinese churches to us. And those Chinese churches, one of them approached us and asked me, am I willing to be the pastor, the full-time pastor? So we just keep it in our mind and we back to Hong Kong and pray about it. And the church leader came to Hong Kong and talked to us once more. And we asked for the approval of God. And it's really amazing. And at that period, we keep praying. And God really sent different kind of people to us. And those people are from that church, that Chinese church in Bradford. It is so amazing. And I still remember one time I go to a local church in Hong Kong to preach. And I just go once a year for that church. And in that morning, there is another pastor came back from Canada. He's not a member of that church. He just randomly went to that church. And after I preach and after the service, I talked to him. And I know that he is graduate from Bradford University, and he's one of the member in Bradford Chinese Christian Church. I was so shocked about when I know about him and his past. So we know that we really get the confirmation to step out and serve God in UK.
You know, when the Bible tells us that if we commit our way to the Lord, he will direct our paths, that's the sort of thing that we should expect to happen. That God will lead us, God will guide us. It's not a step into the unknown. There is sense in which it's unknown, but actually this is the way, walk in it, and God brings us confirmations. You know, people struggle with finding out what the will of God is. Maybe you have, but you know, you're listening to their story, and what they're telling you is when they prayed about it, and God gave a hint here and a little hint there and a nudge there. And together they found out that this was the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning them. And we're glad. What was it like coming to England then from Hong Kong? How did that feel for you?
When we were so excited to come, but before we depart, one month before we depart, I have done a body check, and the doctor said I have 50% chance to have cancer after doing all the blood tests. We are so shocked because God has already opened a way for us to UK. However, suddenly my health has a big challenge. But we believe that if God intended us to serve in the UK, then we just keep our faith and just come here. And then we just step out. Yeah. And so after I came here, and then I need to adapt to the living here.
Yeah.
No matter the setting, no matter the weather, the culture. But I think it's really good for our family, because Ben actually was very, very busy when he was in Hong Kong. He has no time with us every week. So at least we can all stay together.
You got a bit more together.
Yeah.
Wow, so you are not very well. In fact, one of my earlier memories of you after you just started coming to Destiny Church is that we were praying for you and that you've been really poorly. So tell us a little, just a moment about how that is for you now.
I still remember when I was in a critical situation, when I was in hospital, I messaged Mama Rachel to pray for me. And I would really like to thank Destiny Church. I pray with you all together when we are still in the online Sunday service. So I pray when I all of a sudden suffer from the heart failure, kidneys failure during that moment, I pray over the night. I just keep my focus on God. And I just take the faith that God is my healer and I shouldn't be afraid.
You are listening to an incredible testimony here that we know about because we were, you know, on that journey with you. If you've ever doubted that God is a miracle working God, you should not doubt it just from her story alone, because God intervened in her life. She was in a very difficult position. We knew that when we were praying, but God brought you through. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. So you're talking about, you know, you contacted Mama Rachel and all that. So that means that you knew about Destiny Church and here we are together. And how did that all happen then? How did you find us? How did that work?
After we came to UK, I trying to find some church activity for my children. And then I discovered Destiny Church in Wakefield. And I sent an email to Pastor Steve, and then he invited us to the Kids Cup in the summer. My children love it. So I joined the Sunday service as well. Because Ben was serving in the Chinese church, so I went to the morning service with the children, and then afternoon I went to the Chinese church serving with Ben. And I really love it because no matter the setting, the worship, and the people, I feel the presence of God, and it really filled my home church. So I believe that God leading me, leading our family to Destiny Church, to find our destiny.
Yeah, that's great. And you know, things like the children's club that happens in the summer, you see, that's what happens. When we do all these things, people get connected. And that's why we do it, to bless our kids, of course, but also because of opening our doors and making the connections. So that's great. So I got to know you more than I got to know him in those days because he was busy preaching elsewhere and you were coming along with your kids because they just love being at Destiny. But eventually, you know, we got to know one another and well, the rest is history, but it's his story. So let him tell it.
Last year, actually, we think about, because we know many Hong Kong families are moving from Hong Kong to UK sure. at that moment because of the political situation. And many families was choose settling in Wakefield. And we recognize that there are no Hong Kong churches or Chinese churches in Wakefield. And we really want to serve this Hong Kong families. So we set up different WhatsApp group, different group to help the Hong Kong family to get settled, or they need any information before they came to UK. And we just try to help them. And we get many connections with many families, especially those in choose to stay in Wakefield because we stay in Wakefield.
Yeah.
And so we just start to think, can we bring the Wakefield Hong Kong family to a Wakefield church? And we start praying. We pray for a period of time. And that's why we try to talk to Apostle Ian about this and share what our heart is thinking.
Yeah.
And yeah, Apostle Ian just keep sharing with us, pray for us, and ask us to pray for a while, and we meet again, and pray for a while, and we meet
again.
Meet again.
Yeah, that sounds
yeah,
like that.
and we still know, we still remember the prayer we keep doing that, and we keep asking God. And we were really happy that Apostle Yan invites us. I don't know if you can, you still remember your invitation. You invite us to be a part of Destiny family. We really excited and really appreciate that, because we feel that we really can get connect with the brother and sister in the church, and we feel accepted, we feel loved, beloved, and yeah, we really thank God about this.
And you know, that invitation comes out of our heart's conviction. We're not so much, we talked about this, we're not so much excited about having a youth church, an old church, a Cantonese church, a Chinese church, or a Nigerian church, or a Zimbabwean church. We're just interested in the family of God. It has been my vision, conviction, for many years, that church is family. Yes. And some of those people look like you, some of them look like me, some of them look black, some of them brown, some tall, some fat, some small, some old, some young. It doesn't matter. We're family, where everybody is truly, and whoever you are watching this tonight, you're part of Destiny Church Wakefield. We respect you for who you are. We welcome you, and we have a passion for a family which has grandparents, it has great grandparents, it has aunties, it has uncles, and actually we respect the culture and the background. We respect that, but actually it isn't why we're together. We're together because of a kingdom culture. And that's why I said to you, if you're going to do something, and I don't want you to meet as a Cantonese or a Hong Kong families in our building, you'd better become part of our family. And that's my vision, and thank God it seems to be working really well, doesn't it?
And we really thank God that Apostle Ian and the pastoral team really support the Hong Kong family, no matter the translation device, and we can translate in Cantonese in the Sunday service, and also give us the chance to translate the foundation course in Chinese. And
that's very exciting.
Yeah, through the foundation course, the brother and sister from Hong Kong, they really get to know more about Destiny and value, and some of them become a Christian after they came to UK.
Wow.
Yeah, it's really, really good, and really thank God and praise God about that.
Wow, that's very exciting. I just love seeing God progressing. God is going to progress something for you throughout all of my ministry. I've seen God just progress things. You know, God has got a plan. We talk about decisions determine destiny. Decisions determine destiny. When you commit your way to the Lord, God works it out for your destiny. So you must be excited to see all these Hong Kong families now with you and around you. You're translating it to them during the service on a Sunday. And we're definitely excited to see them all. They're part of our family now, and we love them. How do you see that progressing? What do you think is still in the future for that?
We are really happy that our brothers and sisters gradually engage with the church more. So we hope that they will start to get serving in different teams. So it will be helping them more engage with the church brothers and sisters, know more each other, and especially not only develop the relationship with the brothers and sisters, but know how to be faithful in serving in God in the church family. I would like them to get more in touch with and others.
Great.
And on the other hand, we want to encourage those Hong Kong family to spread the gospel, especially to teach our next generation to spread the gospel. Our children, when I was serving in Chinese church, my children came to us and asked the question, "Hey, we are in Chinese church. How can I bring my classmate to church?" And it really came deep in my heart.
But now they can.
Yes. So we have to came together, serve together, spread the gospel together for God's kingdom.
That's a fantastic thing, isn't it? That we can go and share Jesus in the community and make church accessible. to as many people from as many different nationalities, cultures, ages as we can. That's why I've never believed in isolation within the church, but in cooperation within the church. All right, our time is nearly out, so I don't know who's going to go first on this, but in all of these interviews, I've asked a question at the end that says, if you only had 2 minutes to say something really important to somebody, what would it be? So I'm going to ask you to look into that camera in just a moment, and who's going to go first?
Let me go first.
Okay, so you look down the lens of that camera and you tell somebody, this is what I want to say in my 2 minutes, most important thing.
Brother and sister, I just want to encourage you all one thing. Speak life. Speak life. In Proverbs 18:21 said, death and life are in the power of tongue. Speak life. Let us speak the power of God. Speak the word of God rather than your situation, your problem. And speak the provision of God rather than what you lack or what you need. Choose to be love, courage, encourage each other, love each other, and forgive each other, and give thanks to God every day. We can do that prayer every day, right? Say thank you to Jesus, our Savior, and you will experience what you have speak about that. Speak life.
Wow, that's fantastic. Speak life. So much stuff that comes out of people's mouths is not life.
Yeah.
It's discouraging. It's critical. It's gossip. It's, stay away from it. Make sure that you're a speaker of life. Thank you very much. Now, Joanne, it's your turn.
I would like to share, nothing is impossible in God, in Luke chapter 1, 37. There's no situation that is bigger than our God. So you just trust in God, cast your burden upon the Lord, and He will sustain you. I don't know what situation you are now facing. No matter what kind of sickness or disease, obstacle, financial crisis, or relationship problem, God can help you to sort it out. God will make a way for you. So just trust in God. He has a plan for you. He will never leave you and He will never forsake you.
That's spoken by a lady who's had to prove for herself, because she's been very poorly, that there is nothing too big for God to do. He is a miracle working God. He can. Right. Speak life. Believe that all things are possible with God. Thank you so much for joining us this evening as we've been together to have another one of our wonderful editions of This Is My Story. So, Ben and Joanne, this is your story, and the power of your testimony is quite something. God bless you.
Thank you.
Now I'd like to ask you to take just a moment and pray over all the people that are watching your testimony, and pray the blessing of the Lord on them. Will you do that?
Yeah. Father, thank you for your love. Thank you for your goodness. We want to pray for the brother and sister who are watching online right now. We pray for your goodness. We pray for your joy. We pray for your peace. We pray for your blessing upon them, upon their family.
Yes,
we pray that open our eyes. Let us see you more. Open our ears so that we can hear your voice.
Yes.
And let your word become our strength every day so that we can get closer and closer to you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. We love you. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, our Heavenly Father. Thank you for giving us an abundant life.
Oh, yes.
Thank you for giving us Jesus. For His redemption,
Thank you, Jesus. We are safe.
We are not only our spiritual safe, but our physically can be saved. Thank you, Father, for your love. Thank you for Holy Spirit, your guidance in our life. Thank you for teaching us your word so that we can understand how to walk in your path. Thank you for guiding us. We pray in Jesus' name.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Well, this has been a wonderful time that we've been able to spend together this evening. There's more stories still to come. Until then, good night. God bless you. We love you so much.
And the word of our testimony.